Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 76. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Problem 76. We have 1 over x over 1 over x plus 1 over y, and what does that equal? So, again, if you're not familiar with the rules of algebra, you'd say, oh, look, 1 over x on the top, 1 over x on the bottom, let's cancel them. You cannot do that. If it was a times in the denominator instead of a plus, actually you could. But because it's a plus, minus would be the same. You have to simplify it, and it's a much bigger process. So what I'd like to do is make one fraction on the top, one fraction on the bottom, and then the lower fraction, I want to invert it or flip it and multiply times the top one. Now, to get one fraction on the bottom, I'm going to need to find the common denominator. One denominator is an x and the other is a y. I can't put them together until they're the same. I can make them the same by making them both an xy. So to do that, I'm going to multiply the first denominator, the x, times y. If I multiply y times x, I'll get an xy. But if I multiply the denominator times y, I have to multiply the numerator also times y. So I'm really just multiplying times 1. It's not going to change the value of what that fraction was. It'll just change the way it looks. And now the other fraction, the second one, 1 over y, I'd like to multiply that denominator times x to make my xy common denominator. But if I do, I have to multiply the numerator, the one, also times x. So I'm really multiplying times x over x, which is just a big funny looking 1. So for now, the upper fraction of 1 over x will stay as is. But in the denominator, I'm going to have y times 1 is y, and then y times x I'll write as xy. Again, it's most traditional to put that in alphabetical order as opposed to yx. You don't have to, but I'll be traditional alphabetical order. Then plus, and now the second fraction, top times top, 1 times x is x, bottom times bottom, y times x is yx, or again, xy. I like to keep it in the same order so it'll match up. Now the two fractions in the bottom have the same denominator, x times y, so I can combine the numerators. So the upper fraction, again, for one more step, will stay as 1 over x. But the bottom two fractions can be combined over the same denominator, common denominator of xy, y from the first one plus x from the second one. Now, what I can do, I have a fraction made of little fractions. I'm going to take the lower fraction and invert it or flip it and multiply times the top fraction. So the top fraction of 1 over x will stay 1 over x, but now it's going to change to a times because the fraction bar is really a means of dividing. So I change it to a times, and now I flip the lower fraction. The x, y was in the denominator, comes to the numerator, and the y plus x will go into the bottom. So now when I multiply, notice x on the bottom, x on the top, I can cancel these. I can multiply first and cancel, but it's easier to cancel first. So let me get rid of the x in the numerator, x in the denominator. So now what I'm left with on top, 1 times y is y, and in the denominator, y plus x. Now again, y in the top, y in the bottom cannot be canceled because it's a plus in between the two parts in the denominator. So I get an answer of y over y plus x. And as I look at my options, option D is an exact match, y over y plus x, which would be the same as y over x plus y. You can switch the order of the addition to suit the problem you have. But option D is a perfect match for problem 76, and that's the answer.